This here's a jam for all the fellas. Try to do what those ladies tell us.
You gotta know it's gonna go in the pop culture. You know, you cook some gumbo and it's hot, it's gonna come up in a can some damn where. You just better know that.
Welcome back to Grab the Mic, MTV's 20th anniversary hip-hop celebration. I'm Sway, and behind me is the historical East River Park Amphitheater, which was featured in the classic hip-hop movie, Wild Style. Now, by the 90s, hip-hop was no longer confined to block parties, basements, and parks like this. It became mainstream, and hip-hop artists began to cross over into the pop territory. But no one artist made more of an impact than a guy from my hometown, this Oak Town native.
All that. He brought a lot to the game, too, you know what I'm saying? The dancing, that was real big, because, you know, hip-hop was just known for lyrically. He put the dance in it, the party to where the girls wanted to be a part of it.
People might dog him now, but you had your set of Hammer fans. Don't even act like it, you know, with the sad, because when you did that, like, MC Hammer look move and wiggle and go over to the side, everybody did that. Hammer was hot.
I didn't like Hammer. You know, I didn't like Vanilla Ice, and I put them both in the same category. Most of the kids were into Hammer, and I was just like, I remember I used to just be like, why do you listen to this bullshit?
I definitely have the utmost respect for Hammer. He's a young cat that came in the game, did his own thing, did it the way he wanted to do it, and he succeeded.
Hammer was the first Puffy.
You know what I'm saying? As far as like commanding like that big pop success over like the world.
Can't touch this.
Oh man, I knew that was gonna be one of the hugest records ever in hip hop, rock and roll, pop, country.
About him, right? He's like, you can't touch this.
Hammer was raw dog. He did his thing. I actually used to like Hammer.
I mean,
you know what I'm saying? On the real tip. People be talking, you know, talking shit about Hammer, but run up on it.
Hammer beat your
ass. I bet you'll beat your
Hammer ass. Your monk ass. Run up on Hammer.
For real.
Hammer did a lot for MTV. I know a lot of people was watching MTV during the Hammer days. Those videos were unbelievable. I would run to see a Hammer video. If I heard Can't Touch This,
sure, I remember we used to be
flying to the TV.
On the road with him, remember?
Hammer was explosive.
Yes. It's hard to follow him. You know, with the dancing and the whole thing.
Like a circus on stage. He would have like four different things going on. He had a choir over here doing their stuff, Oak Town 357 doing their stuff, he doing the stuff, he got some guys over here doing the stuff, and he just kept you like this the whole time. For me, he like showed me what a real entertainer is, and I hope that he knows that he touched people like me, because I found a lot of respect to him for what he did.
Hammer was big, I mean, what? Can't hate on a man like that. Can't hate on him.
One way he was like Hammer the dancer, the entertainment megastar, and he came back because everybody started talking about how he sold out and everything. He tried to come back hard.
Gossip.
He came back gangster first though. Remember with the skull cap and the loafs on. He had that on, the pumps and the
too legit.
Too legit. He came back. He should have did just do what you do, whatever they say about you. For real.
Let's just do your thing.
Hammer's videos with their outlandish sets, special effects, costumes, and dancers prove that rap music can stand next to its rock and pop counterparts on MTV and open the door for today's big budget cinematic landscapes.
Ooh, I got you all checked. I think that video was a real turning point video. It went from straight hardcore to anything goes.
It was the first video where I think anybody probably changed about 10 different times in 3 minutes. And it was the first video that has ever used a fisheye lens. My performance was magnified, so it was kind of like the first real life animated video, the first real life cartoon.
The rain put it on a whole another perspective. This hip hop girl come in and she's rapping a different kind of way.
Now look, who would be? It be me, 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 and Timothy.
And then she give us this video like the black Linda Blair on a hill, or just she got on this patent leather suit and it's like 20 times bigger than what she really is, so it's just bugged. It was just a bugged out video.
Visually, a lot of our videos used to be kind of grimy and whatever, nothing to them. And they, you know, they made you watch. That made you really want to sit down and see, you know, dang, what's going on here? You know, this is different.
Let me welcome everybody to the Wild Wild West, a state that's untouchable like Elliot Ness.
California,
West Coast.
Pimpin', baby. That's right. Big pimpin', spinning cheese. G, 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 and cheer.
Hot, sicker than your average. Pop a twist cabbage off instinct. Just don't think.
Yeah, them videos is tight, and they were all needed at the time, you know what I'm saying, with the crazy budgets and the fly looks and just taking it to the next level. But then again, somebody like Nelly, you know, then flipped the script and came with a low-budget video, same with Cash Money, No Limit. And they put the game back in the game to show that you don't have to have a lot of money to do a classic video.
Snoop is definitely like a big influence as far as my music anyway, you know what I'm saying? His G-Thing video, I think, when him and Dre did that, I think they really opened a lot of doors up. They probably could have shot it for no more than about 50 grand, you know what I'm saying? But it's worth so much more now.
One, two, three, into the four. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the dope, ready to make an entrance, so back on up.
Before I have to pull the spot to cut.
It was the first video that showed some real LA players having a good time and not mad and mean and grabbing a gun, or you know what I'm saying? That's what West Coast hip hop was known for back then. And we just put a little imping in the pimp and we just slowed it down and had a good time. And like this and like that and like this, Santa.
Cause ain't nothing but a G-Bang, baby. Two moped out G, so we crazy.
Yeah, when we did the Nothing But a G-Thing video, we went out and interviewed quite a few directors and what have you, and nobody was saying nothing that was turning me on. They wanted special effects and, you know, big shiny type videos and what have you, and we wanted to just to be a representation of us, how we felt and what we were doing at the time. So I just decided to direct it myself.
Everybody, come on, jump, jump, jump.
Coming
jump,
up, we jump, look back on jump, MTV's jump, coverage of the monumental, the controversial, and the tragic events that shaped the hip-hop community.
I think to the whole world, it was just like a sad moment.
Sister, as fine as you doing in Philly.
Are you trying to talk to my man?
Please.
I can take care of myself.
MTV's hip opera, Carmen. With Beyonce Knowles, Mekhi Phifer, Mos Def, Rod Digger, Little Bow Wow, Jermaine Dupri, Wyclef Jean, and The Brat. Presented commercial free by Snapple. Premieres Tuesday at 8, only on MTV.
I stand eternally humbled by your glory,
You can always tell who's been to the party. Mario Party 3. New characters, new adventure boards, and over 70 new minigames. You and your friends might want to get some rest. Mario Party 3, rated E for everyone.
Bart, you've got some unique activity in your brain's pleasure lobe. Diagnosis? Butterfingeritis.
No cure?
Afraid not.
Cool. Crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery. Nothing like a Butterfinger.
From Nestle.
Oh, why does Bart always get the good diseases?
98 degrees! I urge you to buy this.
Urge?
You're looking for a feeling that's natural. Baby, all that you need to know is that you got the urge in her
bones. All I said was urge.
Urge? Got the
urge. Proud sponsor of the 98 Degrees Revelation Tour.
Genuine. Optimistic.
Ambitious.
Genuine.
Ambitious.
How do you feel today? Introducing the strength you expect from Secret, now in three new scents. Genuine, ambition, and optimism. Designed to match your style, your individuality, your intensity. And just like you, nothing is stronger. Secret Platinum Protection. Strong enough for a man.
I feel strong.
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 But made for a woman.
Thing about certified used Volkswagens. They'll go the distance.
William Thatcher didn't make the rules.
I won't spend the rest of my life as nothing.
He was born to break them.
Let's dance, you and I.
Yes!
A Knight's Tale, rated PG-13. Opens everywhere Friday.
Oh, grasshopper sitting on a railroad taxing, Polly doodle all day. Picking his teeth with a carpet taxing, Polly doodle all day.
Now, Sprite.com makes it easier to buy just about anything you want. Under every cap is a free Sprite or a Rocket Cash. Online money you can use through Sprite.com. Drink Sprite, get Rocket Cash. Buy what you want.
As they say, mother knows best, particularly on Mother's Day. So this year, why not treat yourself to the easy elegance of my Jacqueline Smith collection? And with my entire line on sale at Kmart right now, it might be a good time to start dropping a few hints.
Ooh, hey. Sassy. Hot.
The 2001 MTV Movie Awards coming June 7th, only on MTV.
The one thing that MTV has been able to do is bring other artists together. From that Daytona Spring Break, me, Busta Rhymes, Tretch, Peppa from Salt and Pepper, we were all hanging out.
That never happened. It was nothing like that. That many rap groups, MTV, same time.
I met Tretch, and then we just kind of like, MTV, you did it.
Welcome back to Grab the Mic, MTV's 20th year anniversary. Look back on hip-hop and rap music. Now, if this place looks familiar to some of you, that's because we're standing smack dab in the middle of Times Square, a place that has become synonymous with MTV. In fact, over the years, there's been a lot of great moments in rap music here on MTV, a lot of them. Let's take a look back at them.
I'm sick of you, little rolling boy. Cause all you do is annoying me, so I have been sitting here to destroy you.
We found so many people that look like him. You know what I'm saying? And they all walk from outside. They were standing outside like it was a line. That was really thought of well.
Cause I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just in my teddy. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up?
Everything, everything,
is everything,
is everything,
hey. What is meant to be will be.
What is meant to be will be.
She is incredible. For me, as another female artist, she's definitely an inspiration. She's intelligent, she's beautiful, she was another dark-skinned woman, and I was like, woo.
Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg, live in the middle of Times Square, NYC, make some noise!
Still the beast bang, still doing
doing my thing. Since I left, ain't too much.
Man, that was a tremendous moment in Times Square. I mean, they shut the place down. LL put on a great show. It was the first time that any established rapper like that came out with a live band and rocked it.
They're gonna show it. I hope y'all laughing in your homes right now. Look at this. Oh my God.
At least I was clean. Could have been worse. I could have been funky beyond belief.
Jump. Tribe's bomb, man, huh?
Yo. Definitely one of the,
I don't know, one of the
top five hip hop groups of all time,
without a doubt.
Can y'all kick me out of? Can y'all kick me out of? Can y'all kick me out
of? How are you gonna ban a record like this in the United States? Freedom of speech, man. I mean, it just made me want to go in and make my records worse.
I'm fresh about my coma. I got my mama and my daddy and my homies in my corner.
I thought it was very cool that he did the song. You know, I thought that song was appropriate for what he was going through, you know what I mean?
It was very daring of him and very daring of MTV.
Murder was the case that they gave me. I'm innocent. I'm innocent.
Performance just made me look at Puffy as a real star. Like, you got Sting on stage with you, dog. You big.
Truly love. Check it out.
Just to know that they had just gone through the whole loss and mourning, and then to see Faith get up there and look so powerful and strong and just so dignified was amazing.
By the spirit of God that it happened like that. Make some positive music to keep the light moving and keep it pushing on.
I thought this was America, people.
The deaths of hip-hop legends Biggie and Tupac raised the question, is it art imitating life or life imitating art? It also posed a challenge for the MTV news department to remain neutral when reporting on the personal troubles of MTV's biggest rap stars.
I know when I was, you know, going through my case, I used to watch MTV and see how they tried to, you know, do me or whatnot, since the media really did me bad, but MTV didn't really do me bad. They, like, opened it up. You know, even with Puffy's situation, they letting you see and understand what went down, saying, oh, they innocent, whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's like you really get a chance. MTV is open, and I appreciate them for that.
I seen Snoop on MTV News the day that the verdict was won.
We, the jury, in above entitled action, find the defendant, Calvin Brodus, not guilty of the crime of murder in the first degree.
They showed the whole reaction, him putting his hand down in his head, and, you know, the crying expression, you know, his man that was securing him at the time, you know, they hugging each other, and, you know, like the whole thing.
Y'all thought I was gonna get found guilty. So y'all had the cameras rolling to be like, we got another one. He's a quick, oh, we can't use this. Y'all just had the flexibility of being there, because at that time I was like a new rapper in the game, and there was so much, you know, surrounding me to where y'all had that action to get inside the courtroom or get an interview with me, because I felt like y'all was the only avenue of releasing what I really felt.
Appreciate that, and I want to thank everybody that prayed for me and my league through this whole ordeal.
They bring to you at home what you ain't gonna get a chance to see, and even if you probably went to the courthouse yourself, and that's what I love the most about MTV, the way I maneuver the tactics of getting in the nooks and crannies to set up that little lens to capture all of this, the behind the scenes, like the fly on the wall.
I think MTV News is like one of the best shows.
MTV News, you hear it first.
I don't think it's particularly brutal. Because see, MTV never could be too biased away from the artist, because if the artist came out of it, they're gonna wanna talk to you again.
Two of America's most wanted.
What do you think you're most known for? Your acting, your music, or the controversy that surrounds you?
My big mouth. My big mouth.
I got a big mouth. Can't help it. I talk from my heart. I'm real. You know what I'm saying? Whatever comes, comes.
I feel so confident and so sure about the man that I am that you can watch me. You can watch me when I fall, when I cry, when I get shot, when I go to jail, when I die. You can watch it.
Hi, I'm Tabitha Soren with MTV News. Controversial rapper and actor Tupac Shakur has died in a Las Vegas hospital of complications from several bullet wounds sustained Saturday night, September 7th. He was 25 years old.
When I heard, you know, Pac got shot, it was like, okay, Pac got shot, he'll be all right.
Picture us inside a ghetto heaven, a place to rest, finding peace through this land of stress.
That I ain't mad at your video. I mean, I like Tupac because it's like a lot of mystery behind him, for real.
I think I like the softer side of Tupac. It wasn't just about partying. It was like, I got something to say. Stuff is stuff that's going on in the world and people need to know.
We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how it's supposed to be. How can the devil take a brother if he's close to me? I let it go back to when we played as kids, but then
we lost somebody very important to the hip hop, to the music industry, period. And, you know, it was a very sad day.
With Tupac, you know what I'm saying? It was a crazy thing to hear that he died. So when it happened to Biggie, it was a little surprising.
Rap star Biggie Smalls, the notorious B.I.G., was shot dead by a drive-by gunman in Los Angeles late Saturday night.
We pulled up to the hospital and I saw the Suburban. And oh, it was just like shot up. And I just think that's the worst thing that could ever happen. And I looked at Jermaine, and he just didn't look right. And I was just like, oh, God. And I think we all just, like, broke down.
It was horrific. As an artist, I didn't even want to rap anymore because it wasn't fun anymore. It was like, who do we have to look up to now?
It just was crazy. It was a real weird feeling, man. Because then at one point, you know, it just didn't feel like it was worth all of this. Like, you know, I'm pretty sure a lot of MCs was just like, we getting in this to make some music. Like, we ain't in this to be dying. I mean, I'm not dying for hip-hop music. I got kids. I die for them. The music is supposed to create a love universally. Music ain't supposed to kill nobody, dog.
Family, friends, and fans of Biggie Smalls are here. They are cheering, and they're paying their last respects to Biggie.
I was in the procession, so I was in the car, and I was seeing it as I was going by. It was like a real emotional moment. Then when you saw it on MTV, like the aerial shots and the side shot, and the fans that got to hear them and hear really what was going on, and seeing it on, you know, MTV, it was so touching that people really cared that much.
The future of hip-hop is going to grow, and I think that is definitely going to grow on MTV.
Well, I'll be damned. We are here in Japan, in Chinatown.
When Wu-Tang was in Japan, and they didn't know our language, and all them kids was there jumping, going crazy, and doing call and response, that was very exciting to me and the whole Wu-Tang Clan.
Cash rules everything around me. Quick, get the money.
So where do we go from here? Hip-hop's future, up next.
Cash rules everything around me. Creek, get the orders.
From the out of creation to the end of time.
MTV 20, Grab the Mic, a hip-hop history is coming to you thanks to Sprite, Obey Your Thirst, and Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Now Sprite.com makes it easier to buy just about anything you want. Under every cap is a free Sprite or a Rocket Cash. Online money you can use through Sprite.com. Drink Sprite, get Rocket Cash. Buy what you want.
Morning. How'd you sleep?
Good.
Ah, I slept great. Must be that fresh mountain air, you know? Nothing like it.
Oh, man.
Introducing the Jetta wagon with room for 70 cubic feet of anything.
Ah, the great outdoors.
I stand eternally humbled by your glory.
You can always tell who's been to the party. Mario Party 3. New characters, new adventure boards, and over 70 new minigames. You and your friends might want to get some rest. Mario Party 3, rated E for everyone.
No film. No residue. Just soft, smooth skin. Introducing Olay Complete Body Wash with an ideal combination of soap-free cleansers and aerated moisture that rinses clean so nothing comes between your skin and your world but the lightly moisturized feeling of clean. Olay Complete Body Wash.
Crunch something? Grab a new Snickers Cruncher. Crispy rice, peanuts, and chocolate. Crunchy. Crunch this.
Celebrate the opening of another Hollywood Tans. Tan in our HT tanning booth for only $5 a tan. Stop in at over 80 locations without ever making an appointment. It's only $5 to tan. Our stores are open 7 days. Tan at the best. Tan for the prom or before your vacation or any time to look and feel better. It's that easy. Stop in or call 877-TANS-123 or visit us on the web at HollywoodTAN.com. You don't have to go to Hollywood to get a Hollywood tan.
Is my future.
Seen this much heat? The World Wrestling Federation and MTV bring you WWF Sunday Night Heat live from WWF in Times Square. Sunday Night sizzles as sports entertainment's biggest stars blaze into the ring. Tonight, catch an all-new WWF Sunday Night Heat at 7, followed by a brand new Undergrads at 8, only on MTV.
MTV opened a lot of eyes to music. A worldly sound. They brought a whole different perspective of music. Multicultural groups are just watching us and people are watching us. So you are gonna tune in, you're gonna watch because we got the mots right now.
Yo, what's up, MTV? We live in Haiti. Haiti, make some noise! Yes, yes, y'all.
Welcome back to Grab the Mic. Right now we're in Harlem, 125th Street, a national landmark, a place that's rich in cultural history, as well as great promise thanks to an economic resurgence in this very important community. It is neighborhoods like Harlem across the country that help provide the soil for hip-hop to grow. In the beginning, it emerged as a voice for people who had no other platform. Now it's a voice you can hear throughout the world. Hip-hop music has influenced everything from today's pop to rock to R&B as well as gospel, and its original style of fashion and dance has influenced everyone from Jennifer Lopez to NSYNC to Madonna. It truly has come a long way. Now let's take a look at its future.
You had to do something in hip-hop to be in the hood. I was saying I'm from the hood. You either had to beatbox, DJ, rap, do graffiti, break dance. You had to do something in hip hop.
Started from street corner and we took it there worldwide.
I think hip hop is just gonna get bigger and bigger. It's gonna move closer and closer to the front of the record store.
Because usually when you go in the record store, you say, yo, where's the rap section? They go, over there. You know what I'm saying?
No matter what they say about hip hop, the one thing that it does do is bring like all different races and all different cultures together.
I just see hip hop growing. I think it's unstoppable. I see it growing, going to different countries, getting more multicultural. I see collaborations with people from other countries, still collaborating with other music.
Better get that dough, sisters.
Be together too.
What you like?
I can't wait to see like a hip hop rap country song. I'm gonna call Dolly Parton and see if she wanna come do TRL with me and we can do a live Daisy Duke song.
Pretty soon it's gonna be rappers gonna be 50 years old. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be people in wheelchairs. Talking about I used to rap, man. You know what I'm saying? Kids born and that's all they gonna know is rap. That's all they gonna know is hip hop because it's the voice of the youth.
Like how the other generations listen to rock and roll that they old, we gonna be still listening to Biggie. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's gonna be crazy. You're gonna be like 70 years old, like listening to Biggie and probably gonna have the old school radio station.
People thought it would die out in 5 years after Run DMC came out. You know, they go, oh, it's a passing phase. Well, shoot. It's a long passing phase then.
People that said hip-hop was just a fad didn't understand it, didn't know what was going on with it, didn't really understand the passion that we had about it. They didn't understand the turntable. They didn't know that these turntables were like guitars and drums to us. And it was, I used to run home to get on the turntables, fight over the microphone. I think they just didn't understand how passionate these kids were.
They ain't like classical music or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Something like people have to acquire a taste or something or learn to love or something like that. It's like instant, boom, I love this. This is it, this is me, man. I'm gonna loosen up my jeans, I'm gonna give me some Tims, I'm gonna give me a do-rag and a ball cap. Oh, I love this, I feel so comfortable. Matter of fact, I'm gonna do this every day. You gotta
believe. First, you gotta warm up, you know.
I'm a shiny ass nigga, man. Let me go on the shine.
That's a big forehead,
man. I ain't with that makeup shit, so I leave here, nigga, think I'm dead.
Y'all gotta get out.
Do my ass, dude.
God, I'm an ass.
Throw shot, dude. Everybody looking at me like.
Yeah. That's Steve. What the hell?
Oh my God.
It's a bug.